This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so can continue from the last session. So in last session we discussed about the profiles. Profiles are stored at OS level whenever we install SAP. Just like whenever we install the OS, for example, if you take this system, this is SAP install system. On Windows 2008 server, we installed SAP. So in C drive, we have OS, and in D drive, we install SAP. In D drive, SAP supported folders are created, like USR. In USR, we have a folder SAP. In SAP, we have CCMS, DEV, preference logs, QA, and trans. Like this, these folders are created. So whenever we double click on any of the folder, we have some folders. Like if you take C dev folder, so we have DVBMGS, SysTemp. So these all are SAP supported folders. In the same way, means whatever the folders are created in C drive, whenever we install OS, the same way, whenever we install SAP supported folders are created. So one of the folder is profile folder. In this folder, we have default profile and a startup profile and instance profile. So these three types of, actually we have three types of profiles. So we have three types of profiles. So default profile, instance profile or instance specific profile, and startup profile. So we have three types of profiles. So these three profiles are located in this location. So you can observe here. This is a default profile. Default.pfl, it's a default profile, and this is the instance profile, instance specific. Already we discussed instance profile should be starts with the system ID dev DVBMGS underscore ECC server. So DEV, it indicates the system ID. So you can observe here, we have two systems, dev and quality. So you can observe here, this is so because of we are in dev folder, so whenever we double click on quality folder, I will show you that one also. So you can observe here, we double click on dev. So now we are going to double click on quality sys profile. Here we have QA, but default profile, startup profile, no changes. No changes means the naming convention is not changed. But if you take instance profile should be starts with system ID dev. This is a quality system, that's why it is starts with the QA. So please refer the last session. So if you have any doubts, just so you can watch the session, you will get the clarity. So this is, and I think last session we discussed about the instance profile or instance specific profile. So what is default profile? Default profile, once we log into default profile, any changes are happened in the default profile. I think we have. Yes, this one. Any changes are happened in the default profile, that is going to be means the changes will affect to entire SAP system, not only one instance. The changes are affected to entire SAP system. That is the default profile. See here. So in default profile, whatever the changes are happened, changes means whenever we add the parameter, whenever we delete the parameter, and any parameter values changed. So all the changes are affected to entire system. That is the default profile. And what about instance profile or instance specific profile? Instance profile, nothing but whatever the changes are happened in the instance profile will affect it to within the instance only. Wherever we logged in that instance only, the changes will not be affected to other instances, means of the entire system. Wherever we logged in that instance only, the changes will happen. So see here, instance specific profile. Whatever the changes are happening in the instance specific profile, the changes will affect within the instance only. The changes will not be affected to other instances, means so the entire system is not affected. Wherever the changes are happened in that instance only, the changes will affect. That is the instance profile. So next one, startup profile. Start profile or startup profile, both are same. Start profile or startup profile. So startup profile is used for to start SAP and shut down SAP. It means, so if you want to start SAP system, just go to SAP MMC and select the system which system you want to start. Just right click on it, Alt or Start. So this is from our side, we are doing like this. So once, whenever we click on Alt or Start from in SAP MMC, system will check whether the startup profile is existing or not in OS level. In OS level, we have a path, na? D drive, means in D drive only we install SAP. In D drive, USR, in USR we have SAP folder. In SAP, we have different folders are there. Preference logs, DEV, QEA, like this. So just double click on the system. For example, DEV. In DEV, we have one more folder, sys. In the sys, we have number of folders are there. One of the folder is profile. So in profile folder, startup profile is existing or not. System will check. If the startup profile is existing, then only system will start. That's what last session already we discussed. It's very, 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 very important startup profile. We should not delete the startup profile in OS level. That's a file, just a file only. Just if you want to delete this one, it's a one second task. Just right click on it and delete it. But once we delete the startup profile, system will not be started. That is a main disadvantage here. That's why, see here, from EHP 7 onwards, startup profile is not available. Because by mistakenly, whenever we delete the startup profile, the system is waste. Means we are not able to start the system. So that's why, for security reasons, from EHP 7 onwards, we don't have any startup profile. That is. Startup profile is used for to start SAP and stop SAP. Whenever we start SAP system, whenever we start SAP, system will check startup profile. In OS level, so we know the path. The path is I'm not mentioning the drive name because in organizations who they are using means so they install SAP on different drives. So that's when I'm not mentioning the drive here, just ESR. In ESR SAP, in SAP we have system ID. I'm not mentioned the DEV, QEA, PRD because so in real time scenarios they're using different names. That's what just I mentioned SID and the system. Sys profile. This is a path. In this path, we have profiles. Default profile, instance profile, and startup profile. So whenever we start SAP, system will check whether the startup profile is existing or not in this path. If the startup profile is existing, SAP will start. If the startup profile is not existing, SAP will not be start. So we should not delete. A startup profile. In OS level. Please remember this one. So OS level access, it's impossible. Means not impossible. Sometimes we need to log into OS level. So in that case also, we should not touch the profile folder. So nowadays no issue because that is not available. Nowadays in SAP we are using EHP 7, EHP 8. So before EHP 7, the startup profile we have. But EHP 7, whenever we are using EHP 7, EHP 8, startup profile is not available. So already I show you already in last session. So again I will show you. So this is a startup, very, very important. So this is startup profile. So I will show you. And one more thing, first the naming convention, we forgot that one. So startup profile naming convention. Start underscore DV EBM GS EVBM EBM GS number. Your host name. This is start means it's going to be start. The system is going to be start and DEV B4 5. And this one, and finally this one. So here D stands for dialogue work process. DIA, D stands for dialogue work process, DIA, dialogue. And V, update, UPD. And ENQ, ENQ. ENQ and B, BZD, background. Yes, spool, SPO. And number means so instance number. This is so instance number. So instance number. Host name SAP installed computer name. SAP installed computer name. Computer name. And M stands for message server. Message server. G stands for gateway. This is the naming convention of startup profile. Start underscore DVBMGS number underscore host name. So here DVBMGS stands for dialogue work process, update work process. It means start. It's going to be start, dialogue work process, update work process, NQ work process, background work process, gate spool work process, message server, gateway. And instance number and computer name. This is so. This is startup profile naming convention. This is a startup profile naming convention. So next one is so please observe this one. Every instance, every instance should have one startup profile plus one instance profile plus one, but default profile is only one. We don't have a number of default profile. Default profile is only one for all the instances. This is every instance should have one startup profile, one instance profile, and default profile. Default profile is only one for all the systems default. So please, it's very important, default profile. So if you take one instance should have, if you take any instance, the instance should have one startup profile, one instance profile. Default profile is common, one default profile. This is, so please, so observe this one. So one instance, if you take one instance, one into one means one startup profile plus one into one plus one means one startup profile, one instance profile. A default profile is common, one. It means three. So one into two plus one equal to three. No? So this is. So if you take one instance, two, it means one startup profile, one instance profile. But default profile is common. That's why we mentioned one. So please remember. If you take one instance, one startup profile, one instance profile, plus one default profile, total three. So if you take one instance, we have three profiles. So you need to say, guys, I think except Nagras, see here. If you take one instance, one into two plus one, equal to three profiles means if we have one instance, we have three profiles. For example, three profiles, how many, sorry, three instances, how many profiles we have? Yeah, Maurice, anything? Three into two plus one.
3 into 2, 6 plus 1 default, 3 instance
yeah.
Means.
It's 7 only, default. Not 9. 3 into 2 plus 1.
But every instant, one default instance. It's
yes, 3 instances, yeah, 3 default, 3 startup profiles, 3 startup profiles, 3 instance profiles.
Yeah,
got it. Three startup profiles plus three instance profiles. How many?
Three plus six plus one
plus
seven.
Sir. One default profile is common, no? So total seven. Yeah. So for example, if we have seven instances, how many profiles we have?
15.
Plus one. 15, right? If we have 15 profiles, 15 instances, how many profiles we have?
31.
Yes, 31, right. For example, if we have 31 instances, how many profiles we have?
63,
right. Good. So if we have 63 instances, how many profiles we have?
127
instances, how many profiles we have?
Two fifty-five.
Yes, correct. So, if we have 255 instances, so how many profiles we have?
510.
511.
11.
510 plus 1, 511.
Yes. So if we have 511 instances, how many profiles we have?
Thousand 23.
1023.
10.
1023. 1023.
Yes, correct. One 0 2 3. Is it correct now? Is it correct?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Confirm?
Yes, sir, confirm.
But this is wrong. Anybody, Vizya? Why it is wrong? I think except Nagras. Is it correct now? 511 into 2 plus 1, 1023 is right.
Calculation wise, it is correct, but
I think this is also wrong. I think this is also wrong. Monish, why these three wrong? 127 into 2 plus 1, 255, right? Correct, na?
Sir. For calculation, we use.
This is one interview question. One of our students he faced recently. The interview is not clear due to only this interview question. Why
I think
these
we
three
have
are
only
wrong?
99 instances are only 00299.
Is it correct, na? Are you confirmed? This is the right question.
Yes, yes. In instance class, you told that 00 to 99 instances are available.
Yeah, that is correct. So we are very. We are very strong in calculation because of fifth class student, sixth class student also they can able to calculate this one. 157 into 2 plus 1, 255. There is maybe fifth class, sixth class student also they can able to say. But we need to concentrate because they confused. So the interview person they know the calculation. We are also know, but why he is pressing? Why he is asking this? We need to concentrate that one. But unfortunately, our student he focused on only calculation. That's why the interview is not cleared. So because for confusion purpose, so they asked these things. So how many? If we have one instance, how many profiles? Three. If we have three instances, how many profiles? Seven. Seven profiles. Seven instances. How many? They ask. For confused purpose, so they ask like this only. So we need to say we don't have 127 instances, we have only 00 to 99. But this is correct because 63 only. So this is one of the integration. Please remember this one. So every instance should be having one startup profile, one instance profile. The default profile is only one. If we have 90 instances or 99 instances, we have only one default profile. If we have 99 instances, 99 into 2, 2 means 99 startup profiles, 99 instance profiles, plus one default profile. That is, got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So next thing is actually yesterday we got an issue in my organization. I will explain you that one. So I think everybody you are very strong in client administration, right? So in client administration, what happened? Yesterday it is a big issue in my organization. I will explain you that one. So in FCC4 we have clients, the list of clients, right? For example, I think already I told you a lot of times in production systems, especially in production systems, it's very dangerous. So very carefully we need to do anything in production systems. If there is any scenario, we need to do anything in the production system. So very carefully need to do. So for example, in this system, we have so many clients are there. One client I'm going to set as production. Maruti Motors, okay. So 150 client, I'm going to assign production system. So you can observe here why I'm changing is no changes are allowed because this is production system. Changes are not allowed. Changes are allowed. Changes are allowed only for development and quality only. In production system, changes are not allowed. This is production system. I change it to production system. This is. Yes, you can observe here. So you can. Yes. This is 150 client is a production system, right? SC06 is one of the T code. System change options. Yes, in SC06 the window is look like not modifiable because that is production system now. That's why the client is not modifiable, means modifications are not allowed. That's why in SC06 we have not modifiable, and in namespace also not modifiable. This is so in some scenarios we need to open the client. What is the meaning of client to open? what is the meaning of client open? So sometimes we need to change some minor activities in production system, but we know already for access of production system we need approvals. I think 5 to 6 approvals we required. So once we got the approval, only even we have user ID password in production system, whenever we have the user ID password also, you should not log in. Okay, login is okay, but we know the user ID password, but we should not log in. Login also, it's going to be a big issue. So once we know the process, we need to raise a request, admin change for our manager. We are going to be use basis 888 user. So because I'm also facing same issue yesterday, that's what this is very time means. I'm also new for this activity. That's what I'm explaining. So in real-time organizations, what happened? So in our user ID. So for example, my user ID is at 600002 6570. That is regular user ID. But if any changes are required in the systems, like production system, we have separate user ID password. That's a super user ID. It's very, very rare conditions only we can use that user ID. Not regularly. In very rare conditions only we can use that user ID password. For example, if you want to log into 800, so this is my regular user ID. I'm using this my ID, but some activities we should not use our user ID. We should use SCP super user ID. So that is so I'm going to create that one. This is super user ID in my organization. That's what I'm creating this one. The user should have SAP underscore all and SAP underscore new. So that is special user ID. So please remember that is not our our regular user ID. And one more thing, before using this one, we need to send a mail to, because we know the user ID password, we know. But before log into SAP, we need to inform to our manager. We are going to use basis 800 client. some mail ID is there, na? So there. IBM, for example, IBM.com. So that is our manager ID. And in CC, we need to mention our DL. So our base is real. So SISC. Like this, so we have DL, our DL, so our base is DL. In subject, base is hyphen 800 client, the user in some the project, my project name, dev system S4. S4 HANA system, S4 dev. For example, D4G. The system ID is D4G. Just like dev quality, the same way, D4G. Not exactly as per your organization systems. D4G system. IT. No. So first we need to send to our manager, na? Like Krishna. So whenever we raise a request, please approve. Below admin change. So here we need to mention the IBM. That is our this is the admin change request number. So always we should dilate this request number. Base is 800 client user uses in the project S4 dev system, that is D4. So like this, first we need to send a mail to our manager for approval purpose. Once we got the approval, then only we need to send a mail to a security team. It means in our organization, if we have say separate security team, we need to send a mail. So we are not mentioned any security name because we don't know. That's why we mentioned the DL only. So here we need to mention our manager. IT. Please share basis 800 user. Password also, user password. So user is basis, we need password. So here just we mentioned so means once we got the approval from manager, then only we need to send a mail to a security team. Even we have the user ID password, because if any of the team member have the password of basis, but we should inform to security team, otherwise it is going to be a big problem in auditing. So that's why we need to send a mail to security team if we got the reply or not, the whatever it may be, that's a secondary thing, but we need to send a mail to security team. If we got the mail, that is fine, otherwise one of our colleague in basis, we have the basis user ID password. So once we send the mail to security team, then only we need to log in. Up to that, we should not log in. So every activity is going to be tracking. Even we know the user ID password, we have the user ID password, everything, but we should not log in. Every second, every minute is going to be a tracking. In auditing, that's going to be a big issue. And one more thing, very, very, very important thing. If you have the T code, SU01 T code. So first I'm going to log in. So first time the user is logged in, that's why it asks the password. See here, our organization will purchase the user IDs. So whatever the users we are going to create at SU01, the user IDs are not free. Every user ID is a cost. So we should not create like a number of users in practice time. Okay, no issue. This because so we are using our system. That is the IDS system only. But in real time, we should not create the user IDs until unless you got the mail from approval mail from manager. Whenever we create a user ID, there is going to be a charge. Sometimes that is going to be a very big penalty. So you should not create, even though if we have user ID, means the T code, SU01 T code also, you should not create. Means because of our organization purchase, every year our organization purchase the user IDs, because the users are employees are recruited now. So that's why for those users purpose, so organization every year purchase a number of user IDs. For example, this year in 2021 to 2022 financial year, our organization maybe 50 user IDs. Those 50 user IDs only we can use along with the existing user IDs. We should not exceed the 50 user IDs, whatever our organization purchased. We should not exceed even 51 also not to create. So whenever we create 51 user IDs, that is going to be a big issue. SAP will like a penalty. It's a big amount. They collect the big amount from our organization. So very, very, very important. So that is not only production system, that is not only quality system. In any system, we should not create SU01 user IDs. So until unless we got the mail from manager. Okay, so see here, so we logged in because we got the approvals from manager and we got the user ID password from security team. That's why we logged in. So once we logged in, go to SEC4. One of the client is production system. Some changes we required in production system, that's what. So double click on production system, because this is production, no changes allowed. You can observe here, changes are not allowed. If you want to do anything, it's not allowed in 150 client. Present, we are in 800. Once we log into 150 client, that is not allow any changes, because that is no changes are allowed. So that's why we need to open the client. How to open a client? Present, the client is closed, means no changes allowed. The client is closed. So I'm going to open new session and enter the transaction code. SE06 is a T code. Please remember SE06. Here, system change options option is there. System change option. Just click on this one. Obviously, software component and software component and namespace should be in not modifiable, because the client is closed, not open. Changes are not allowed. So that is in not modifiable. So we need to change this one. So how to change this one? Just go to edit. Here we have software component modifiable. Just select that one. So sometimes so that is not selected. So better to go to global settings. Just click on modifiable. In place of not modifiable, modifiable. Okay, so now go to edit, modifiable. You can observe here, but only software component only modifiable, not namespace. Again, go to edit, namespace modifiable. Now see here. Now go to SEC4 window. We need to open in change mode. Present is in, this is in disable mode. Just click on display change. Double click on the production system. Changes without automatic recording. So we need to radio button, change the radio button from no changes allowed to changes without automatic recording. Next, this one also, the first two, changes to repository. Save this one. This is nothing but client open. Now all the changes are allowed in 150 client. So once the activity is done, for example, any printer activity or anything, so we'll discuss later how to do printer. Actually, we did a printer activity, that's what I'm saying. So once the printer activity is done in production system, we need to close that one. How to close? Again, go to SC06. Present, that is open, no? That's because modifiable. So select the option not modifiable. At the same time, here also go to software component not modifiable, and again edit not modifiable. Back again, we can check whether that is affected or not. Okay, that is not modifiable only. Save this one and go to SEC4 also. We need to reset the options. So no changes allowed. And here also, the last option, no changes to repository. Save this one. This is done. It's completed. So this is nothing but how to open a client and close it. Close, how to open and close client. And the thing is, what happened, I think 1 year back, one of my colleague, what he did is he opened production client. Yes, he opened production client, that is 150. But unfortunately, he forgot to close this window, not record. So unfortunately, he's forgot it. Close this window. Just he entered SSC4, double click on the client. He log off, means his shift is completed, he log off. So this is going to be a big issue. This is a big issue happened, because once the client is open means just we double click on the client only. We are not did anything. We are not doing anything here. So what he did is just double click on the client, but he forgot to back. this is the initial window, actually. This is the initial window, but he forgot. Come to the initial window, he forgot. Just he opened. This window. He forgot. I think 1 hour, I think. This is a big issue in my organization. That's not my organization, any organization. Because once we open in SEC4, that is not accessible by any other person. Because the 150 is accessed by the user, current user. This user. So any of the user is not able to open this one. Already we discussed SU01 activity, right? Once we open any user profile, except me and any other users are not able to access, because the user is locked for me, because I'm doing some changes in the user. In the same way, 150 client, I'm accessing 150 client. That's why remaining any people, they are not able to access 150 client, because that is locked for us come to back window. So that is locked. So this is a big issue. So please remember, in real-time scenarios also, you are in any window, that is SU0 window or SEC4 window or any other window. First, we need to come to the initial window. Okay, it's not a, actually, generically, whenever we think that's not an issue for our point of view, but that is created a big issue. I think four escalations, team leader, project manager, AP region, Asia Pacific region head, I think, Sridhar. Management people, it's think four to five escalations is happened. So don't open any T code. So if we are in any window, just come to our initial screen. This is our initial screen. Otherwise, that is going to be a big issue. And until unless we got the approval, we should not do anything, because every second is going to be count. Every second is going to be count. So for example, we raise the request at 12, at 9 a.m., 9:05 a.m., we raise the request, 9:05 a.m. So we know user ID password, basis user ID password, we know. Basis is user ID password, we know. In 800 client. So what we think is, okay, we have, means we send the mail. So we know user ID password. So once we send the mail at 9:05, before approve the mail, for example, at 9:15 or 14, for example, 14. Whenever we logged in, but the thing is, the mail is approved at 9:15, but 1 second before, 1 second you logged in, the mail is approved, because we know the user ID password, no? That's why you logged in. Mail is approved at 9:15, but 1 second before mail approved, you logged in, because we have user ID password in our hand. So this is also going to be a big issue. 1 second also, not 1 minute, 1 second also going to be a count in auditing. Okay, so please remember, these are not covered even our concepts. So whatever we face in the organization, that I'm explaining that those only. So that is maybe useful for our future also. Okay. So this is our today's session. We'll discuss, I think, background jobs or operation modes. We'll discuss in our coming session, that is on Monday.